Brexit. Talking about Brexit. Talking about Brexit ever since the sun went down. Now, once there was a land, a proud and pretty land. Green pastures of plenty rolled out unto the horizon. Curling smoke plumes from stone cottage stacks gently rising. And in this pretty land, this proud and pretty land, there lived a wise and just, strong and sturdy people, united and fair. Like two hands beneath a steeple. The lords with the peasants, their wealth they would share. From the maiden's womb to the dead man's tomb, not a soul had a care. The cows in the paddock would queue by the dozen. Red meat was never too rare. The price you paid for what you wanted was always fair. Then along came the EU, and all these lovely things did fall into disrepair. Talking about Brexit. Talking about Brexit. About Brexit ever since the sun went down. The resolute spiky church steeple got trampled underfoot by the great grandson of Mr. Hegel. Across the ancient ley lines, Count Dracula installed his cobwebs of humble grocery servants. Cheese, insidious cheese of yonder yellow colours came tumbling over the almighty green-cut hills, blotting the pretty land with melodious odours and yeasty trumpet calls. Bald-headed eastern men overturned the very bedrock of thy stately homes. They fooled the simple landlords with the age-old smokescreen of hard work and measly pay. Beautiful women came to taunt and tease with black veils and too many clothes. They sent the lords and stewards shrieking to the nearest private cubicles. As they crossed the channel, seamen jumped in panic off the proud white cliffs. Oranges bounced off the heads of the villagers and frightened little children. The warlords ceased to be fair. They stamped out the campfires and taxed your bedroom fares. Butter was replaced with ghee, coffee replaced tea, he with she, glee with bee. All of a sudden, nothing was free. Good times have become all but too few, and it was all because of the godforsaken EU. Talk about Brexit. Talk about Brexit. Talk about Brexit ever since the sun went down. A proud and pretty man. A blonde pubic tuft instead of a head. A picturesque evocation of an inbred git with two eyes wandering towards his nose. An aristocratic peanut perched aloft the country's you-sprung shtick. The home county toffee men crawled from their grass-tickled bungalows and praised him as their Johnson. He threw his peanuts aloft and he turned up his Johnson and he sent the dratted EU to the dogs. He made the country free once more. The Indians came begging for Manchester cloth. The Chinese sent concubines and pleaded for more opium. The South Africans offered gold. The Aussies pledged to take the prisoners. The Americans begged to buy some tea, and all the world was united and free. about Brexit ever since the sun went down.